Welcome back. You're watching Opening Fire. Markets have dulled down. So 57.32 on the Nifty. That's marginally higher by 5 points. Sensex also a 0.25% gains this morning. Let's take a look at IDEA. They've got the big beat on the numbers coming in from the company. Reported PAT of 462 crores versus 308 crores. That was an uptick of 50% quarter on quarter. Sales grew by 8% quarter on quarter. Joining us right now, we've got to Mr. Himanshu Kampania. He's the managing director of the company, joining us to take some questions. First off, let's talk about the margin picture on the EBITDA side, higher than expected. Will that be sustainable?
We are hoping that the investors will cheer to IDEA's performance. You're right, our EBITDA margins have for the first time crossed 30% with a 31.8% EBITDA margin on IDEA consolidated. We have grown our EBITDA margin by 5.7%. There are multiple drivers for growth of EBITDA margin. These drivers are double revenue growth, both on voice side as well as on data side, as well as the benefits that the company is getting from scale and better cost management. Let me handle each of the topics. Starting with better cost management, we started an exercise 2 quarters back to be able to reduce trade expenses, and which has really helped us bring down our churn. Our churn over the year has gone down from 10% on a quarter basis to now at 5% level. And this has helped our subscriber acquisition and marketing cost go down by 3.8%. The second area that we are getting benefit remains our traditional strength area of volume growth. There has been a 12.5% volume growth on voice and 92.2% volume growth on data. The third and equally important area is improvement in RPM. The average realized rate has improved by 2.5 paisa per minute and almost 6% over the year. Now, let me hasten to add that ARPM has a component of both voice and data revenue. The voice realized rate are now at levels what it was in quarter 3 FY12, and we have been able to hold data realized rate. That is why our VAS contribution has gone up from 15.2% to 16%.
Mr. Kampania, during the quarter, churn has gone up and also SG&A expenses are down, focusing more on profitability?
So our long-term mission remains on growth, which is consistent, which is competitive, which is sustainable, and which is profitable. And IDEA in this quarter has tried to achieve objectives on all the forefront. Let me start with the consistency. This quarter, we are reporting a 7.8% revenue growth against last quarter revenue growth of 8.6%. And even in quarter three, we reported a 5% revenue growth. On the second front, which is competitive, quarter four 2013 results have come. And based on TRI results, we have improved our competitive position by 0.9% on an RMS basis. And similar improvements have been observed on VLR share as well as minutes market share. On sustainable growth, we believe the company has been very consistent in their investments on network. And our GSM coverage now extends to over 300,000 villages. Our consumer profile has a balance of affluent consumers as well as bottom of pyramid consumers, and we continue to maintain among the world's lowest voice tariff as well as world's lowest data tariffs. That is why we believe that this growth is sustainable. And finally, if once we achieve all the three, then profitable growth is extremely important to us. And we're happy to report a 44.6% EBITDA margin growth.
The RPM grew by about 6%, which surprised the street quite positively. But are these numbers sustainable?
So let me tell you the process that we followed after the November 2012 auction. When we went back, our seven licenses, we started clamping down on free minutes and promotional minutes for new customers, and that result was seen in quarter four by a sharp fall in the churn rates. So this quarter, what we started doing was we started clamping down on similar promotional minutes that was available to our existing customers. So we have modified our value vouchers, which give discounts in the marketplace. We believe if there is no disruption in the marketplace, then a disciplined telecom sector will be able to sustain the current level of price points. But having said that, having achieved the current voice tariffs, our current now focus is to go back to subscriber growth and volume growth. While quarter two is going to be a weak quarter, we wait to see in quarter three what is the outcome of elasticity on the changes that we have done.
Right. For this quarter, you are seeing a marginal uptick. I mean, this time around, overall, are there any gains, one-time gains that have contributed?
I won't have a specifics to be able to answer how the accounting of Bharti is. Clearly, from our side, it is there are two important components on the this quarter. First and foremost, we used to get an IRU income, which was shown in our quarter four results, which is no more available in the quarter one. That is why if you were to do a comparison without IRU income of last quarter, you'll see a revenue growth of 7.9. A second factor is in this dividend, which is reported in Idea's standalone revenue. I'm not sure what happens for other operators. And we've got a boost from in this dividend of over 84 crores of revenue. So these are the two factors that help.
Can you run us through the MOU and traffic this quarter?
So as we said that on an overall basis, there were a lot of free minutes and discounted minutes that was being offered in the by Idea Cellular across circles, especially in our emerging markets, and we have clamped down on them. Some of the minutes obviously was expected to vanish, and more of them were on the nature of idea-to-idea calls. So this was a part of an overall game plan.
You've also taken 3,750 crores of equity raising. Can you tell us what that's going to be used for?
So let me first start with based on this quarter financials, Idea's overall net debt to EBITDA is at the lowest level at 1.39. We are generating sufficient cash flows. We have generated this quarter a cash profit of over 1,750 crores. So from that perspective, we are able to fund all our CAPEX requirement for this year and going forward. However, as you are aware, Idea's licenses come up for renewal in 2015 and 16, and we wait to hear from DOT on the final license renewal charge. So that is one lumpy payment that the company will have to do. There is also DOT currently holds more than 50% of total spectrum that is the raw material for telecom companies. We are hoping that the TRAI valuation of spectrum makes it encouraging for operators to be able to make investments on the spectrum to be able to manage huge growth that we expect across the GSM and wireless broadband space. So I repeat that the approval that is given by a board is a enabling provision which allows us to inject capital. That does not mean that we would inject capital. We will closely watch the situation. It gives us time. We have to go next to our shareholders. And after that, it gives us 12 months time to be able to take the call whether we need to inject capital or not in the company.
Got that. Mr. Kampania, thanks very much for joining us. Really appreciate taking out the time and explaining the numbers for Idea Cellular this quarter. We're taking a short break right here, but on the other side, focus is going to be on the oil marketing pack management. That's IOC and BPCL will be joining us.